Now, there's a lot of people that are adding lemon to their tea to get a little boost of vitamin C, which you would think is a good thing. But here's the problem with doing that. Lemon has about 23 milligrams of vitamin C, which is a good amount, but the vitamin C in lemon is very sensitive to heat. That vitamin C starts breaking down at just 86 degrees Fahrenheit, which is 30 degrees Celsius. And there's significant damage to that vitamin C structure at 140 degrees Fahrenheit, which is 60 degrees Celsius. So it would be much better if you let your tea cool down a little bit before you added the lemon. Now, also, if you're going to add lemon from a jar that you would buy at the store, realize it's pasteurized. So it's already been cooked, and there's not a lot of natural vitamin C that comes with that product, unless they add vitamin C after the fact, but they usually add some synthetic ascorbic acid, which is not the total vitamin C complex. In fact, it was the pasteurization of milk back in the early 1900s that was blamed for increasing infantile scurvy, which is a vitamin C deficiency, a major one, because the pasteurization destroyed vitamin C in that milk. Now, the other really cool thing about preserving vitamin C is that vitamin C and citric acid, which is in that lemon, has the ability to preserve this phytonutrient that's in the tea by 5x. So the phytonutrient, the plant-based chemical called catechins, which is responsible for a lot of health benefits. Now, you may have heard about this when associating this with green tea, because sometimes on the back of label, when you read green tea, it'll have EGCG. This is just one type, but it's responsible for a lot of health benefits. When you're trying to get these phytonutrients from the tea, your own digestion destroys about 80% of this. But the citric acid and the vitamin C in the lemon will help you retain the phytonutrients so it's not destroyed. Also, vitamin B1 and vitamin B5 are also very heat sensitive. So this is just another side note to encourage some raw foods with your cooked foods. All right, thanks for watching. Before you go, if you have a question about a product, or you're new to keto and you want to know how to begin keto, or you're on keto and you need a debug because it's not going as smooth, I have a keto consultant standing by to help you. This is just for the people in the US. Hopefully, in the future, we'll be able to answer everyone's call. But I put the number down below so you can call and get some help.